summary of this particular equations. So the first equation which we have seen is nothing but the for received power. So if you are talking about the PR in the dBs, it will be 10 log, I'll write here 10 log of PT plus 10 log of PR, sorry, GR plus 10 log of GT minus, you can say, or you can write it in another word, you can write this as a minus LS, or you can write the complete equation which we have seen previously, which is nothing but the, so I'll write here, you can write here 10 log, which is nothing but the dB. So 10 log of PR is equal to 10 log of PT plus 10 log of GR plus 10. I have written here twice. So one is GT and one is GR. Gain of the transmitting antenna and gain of the receiving antenna. So you can write is 10 log either lambda by 4 pi d square, or you can write here minus 10 log 4 pi d by lambda square. Both are having the same meaning. So this is the first equation, and the second equation which we have seen is nothing but the LS, which is nothing but a 32.44 plus 20 log of the frequency, or frequency must be in the megahertz, plus 20 log of the distance. Now your distance must be in the kilometer. Now do remember these two equations, because we are going to solve problems based on these two equations. So the next one is nothing but the, now again I'm going to recall what Poynting theorem tells about the field strength at the receiving antenna. So if I'm interested in, now we have talked about the received power, we have talked about the free space path loss, now we are going to, we must understand what should be the field strength at the receiving antenna. So if I want to know the field strength at receiving antenna, how I can calculate this field strength? So according to Poynting theorem, what is it? I'll use here a Poynting theorem. So using Poynting theorem tells us that if I'm interested in like power density at the receiving side, so I must know what is the electric field intensity and what is the magnetic field intensity. So this is nothing but the power density of your practical antenna. Now we know that E by H, we have already calculated this E by H, which is nothing but the neta, which is nothing but the free space impedance. Now this is for free space. This is the impedance, but it is only for the free space. Now in scalar form, if I want to write this particular equation, agar aapko isko, now I have write it in the vector form. Agar scalar form mein likhenge, to WD is equal to E into E by neta, because I have just rearranged the terms neta. Okay, so agar yahan pe aapko replace karna hai h ko, to you can replace your h with the e by neta. So again, if you solve it further, it gives me e square by neta. Now this is nothing but the power density, which I'm going to denote in the watt per meter square. Or you can again simplify it further, like e is equal to like WD into neta, which we have already calculated, and WD, you know that this is nothing but the GT PT divided by 4 pi d square into 120 pi. So further solving, you will get, like we have already saw such kind of equation previously, so if you solve it further, it will give you 30 GT PT, sorry, I'll write here GT PT divided by d. Now as this is the distance square, it will be out of square root, and this will be, now as I'm talking about the intensity, it will be volts per meter. Agar ye power density hota, to ye hota watts per meter square. So this is nothing but the how you are going to calculate the field strength at the receiving antenna. If you know the electric field intensity, or if you know the gain of transmitting antenna, power of transmitting or transmitted power, and the distance, you can easily calculate the field strength at the receiving antenna. Now next one is nothing but the, now this is not related with this unit, but if you know the open circuit voltage, and if you know the length, effective length of that antenna, again it is very easy for you to understand what will be the received or electric field intensity. So in terms of open circuit voltage, if I know VOC, which is nothing but the open circuit voltage of an antenna, and if I know the effective length of the antenna, so this will be the effective length of an antenna. So if I know these two things, I can calculate. So VOC is equal to E into LE. So if I know these things, I can calculate that VOC divided by LE. VOC open circuit voltage and LE is nothing but the length of the antenna, or this is the effective length, not a complete length, the length which contributes in reception of that particular thing. Okay, so this is all about. So again, if I'm going to summarize all the things, I'll summarize. I have seen received power, I have seen path loss, I have seen electric field intensity at the received side receiver, I have seen the electric field intensity in terms of open circuit voltage and the effective length. Now let us solve some of the problems based on this. So I'll solve first problem. The only request is that you also contribute in solving this. So very straightforward problem is there. So meanwhile, you take your pen and paper, you take your calculators. I'll start writing this problem. So your problem one is nothing but the, now this problem is based on whatever equations we have seen previously. Okay. So this is in a satellite communication system. In satellite communication system, the height of the satellite is 36,000 kilometers. Okay, I'll write this first and then you can write what is given. So this is 36,000 kilometer above Earth and operated at 4,000 megahertz. So the operating frequency is given. The gain of the transmitting antenna. Now here the gain is given. So the gain of the transmitter, a transmitting antenna, is 20 dB. So gain is given, that is 20 dB, and receiving antenna, gain of transmitting antenna and receiving antenna is 40 dB. So aapka transmitting antenna ka GT 20 GR dB. So for this one, you need to find the first, A is nothing but the free space transmission loss, the free स्पेस ट्रांसमिशन लॉस. आपको क्या फाइंड आउट करना है? एल एस, जो हमने अभी देखा. द सेकेंड वन इज नथिंग बट द पावर रिसीव्ड. द नेक्स्ट थिंग विच वी आर गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट, द पावर रिसीव्ड वेन पावर ट्रांसमिटेड इज 200 वैट. नाउ हियर वी आर गोइंग टू एज्यूम free space condition. I hope you are writing with me. Theek hai? So in satellite communication system, the height of the satellite is 36,000 kilometer above the Earth and operated at 4,000 megahertz. The gain of transmitting antenna 20, receiving antenna 40. Now we are going to solve first thing, that is the free space transmission loss. Theek hai? Pehle hum log wo solve karte hai. I'll write what is given there. I can see that the height of satellite is given, that is D is given, that is nothing but the 36,000 kilometer. The second thing is given, that is frequency, which is nothing but the 4,000 megahertz. Gain of the transmitting antenna is given, which is nothing but the 20 dB, and gain of the receiving antenna is also given, which is nothing but the 40 dB. So hum log pehle jo first find out karna hai, that is the free space transmission loss. So how we are going to calculate the free space transmission loss? For that we have seen that LS is equal to 32.44 plus 20 log to the base 10, you can say a frequency, but this frequency must be in the megahertz, plus 20 log of distance, which must be in the kilometers. So if I write all these things, 32.44, all the things are straightforward given here. So frequency in megahertz, you have given it is in the megahertz, which is nothing but the 4,000. So 20 log, distance is also given in the kilometers. So 36,000. So this is a very straightforward question. I hope you are solving with me. So plus, if I do this 20 log, if I do this 20 log, it's 4,000. So it gives me, I think, 72.04. So I'll write this 72.04. If I talk about the 36,000, 20 log of 36,000, it gives me 91.12. So this will be nothing but I'll write it here. So all the addition, 91 plus 72.04 plus 32.44, it gives me the 195.60. So final answer is 195.60. Now, as this is the path loss and we are going to calculate, the path loss unit, if I see, is nothing but the dBs. So all these things that they have given in the dBs. So I'll write, I'll conclude this LS in dB is equal to 195.60. ठीक है, आपने पाथ लॉस फाइंड आउट कर दिया. नाउ दिस विल बी इन द डीबीज. नाउ इट्स वेरी इजी फॉर यू टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट विल बी द रिसीव्ड पावर देयर. सो लेट अस मूव टू कैलकुलेट द पावर रिसीव्ड. नाउ वी नो व्हाट इज द फॉर्मूला ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर पावर रिसीव्ड. सो यहाँ पे आपका नेक्स्ट आ जाएगा पावर रिसीव्ड. सो आई एम कैलकुलेटिंग इट बी पावर रिसीव्ड. सो अगेन आई एम रिवाइजिंग व्हाट वी हैव सीन. ये इसका क्या फॉर्मूला है रिसीव्ड पावर का. सो पी आर इज इक्वल टू, इफ आई एम इंटरेस्टेड इन द डीबीज, सो दिस मस्ट बी इन डीबी. सो पी टी मस्ट बी इन डीबी प्लस जी टी मस्ट बी इन डीबी प्लस जी आर मस्ट बी इन डीबी माइनस एल एस एंड दिस मस्ट बी डीबी. ये हम लोगों ने पहले से फाइंड आउट किया है. पी टी इन डीबी, फॉर दिस दे हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन यू समथिंग प्रीवियसली व्हेन वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट द प्रॉब्लम. दे हैव गिवन यू द पावर रिसीव्ड व्हेन द पावर ट्रांसमिटेड इज थ्रू 100 वैट. सो दे हैव गिवन हियर ट्रांसमिटेड पावर विच इज नथिंग बट द 200 वैट. अगर ये वैट में किया दिया है तो यू नीड टू कन्वर्ट इट इन टू द डीबी. सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू कन्वर्ट इट इन टू द डीबी, 10 log to the base 10, 200, which is nothing but the 23 dB. So you put all the values which are in the dBs. So PR in a dB is equal to PT in dB, 23 dB. GT they have already given, I think GT we have calculated or they have given is nothing but the 40 dB hai, and another one is nothing but the 20 dB. So 40 dB, 20 dB minus path loss, which we have calculated 195.61, which this is also in the dB. So if you calculate this one, your received power will become minus 112.60, and this is nothing but the dBs. So, और ये होता है आपका, अगर आपको इसको watts में convert करना है तो straight forward, this is nothing but the 10 log of minus 112.60 is equal to PR. So this is log of PR is equal to minus 112.60. ठीक है, dBs में conversion. So आपका PR is equal to 11.26. This is the minus divided because I have made it divided by 10. ठीक है, so log of PR is minus 11.26. ठीक है, सो अगर आपको इसको स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड कन्वर्ट करना है तो पी आर इज इक्वल टू 10^-11.26, एंड दिस इज द वे हाउ यू कैन कैलकुलेट दिस पर्टिकुलर पावर इन टू द वैट. सो दिस, इफ यू सॉल्व दिस थिंग्स, यू विल गेट दिस पावर इज 5.5 पीको वैट. ठीक है, सो योर रिसीव्ड पावर विल बी 5.5 पीको वैट. पीको वैट मीन्स 10^-12. You try to solve this particular equation and get this particular